is beautiful.
It's a beautiful guitar.
I'm gonna hand this back to you.
I don't.
And
I've got a special one here if you want
to
see it.
Yeah, I'd love to see it. Now you have four BC Rich guitars. Why four?
Basically, we have two tunings for the live show, so just one main, one spare in each tuning.
Okay.
Very simple. This one, the guys made for me for my Axe Wound project. It's actually a little bit, if you don't like naughty words, look away. But it got some cool custom inlays on that, and a sick custom finish. They've never done this, well, I don't even know what it's called, because they've never done it before.
This looks like a metallic, I would call it like a metallic, it's a metallic silver,
yeah.
But it's got like a black mat in it. May I?
Of course.
Beautiful, we'll train again.
Yeah, man.
And I don't want to hit you.
No, man, it's all good.
This is amazing. You know, it's not only the fit and finish. The fit and finish obviously has a lot, you know, it makes it look awesome, but it's, again, it's very, very, it's got a nice weight, this guitar. Now, this one has an 81 and an 85?
Yep.
Okay. Yep. And these are actually metal-covered EMGs.
Yeah, they've done some kind of treatment to them, which makes them kind of just sit a little bit better with the guitar, like just the shades of the guitar, rather than black ones sticking out, you know?
Okay. This is the MT-02, so this is number two.
Yep.
This is a special guitar.
It's a very special guitar, yeah.
Two volumes, volume?
Yep, don't need no tone. For me, it was just an unnecessary piece of circuitry, which I didn't need.
Gotcha.
I never used, didn't want it, never needed it, so why not just have volume for both?
No, I love
simple,
it.
Simple, right?
I love the custom inlays, that's awesome.
Yeah, I just wanted something that just had a little bit of attitude and, you know, yeah. Kind of says it all.
No, this definitely has attitude.
Yeah.
And same type of thing, we have a full neck through, string through, it's beautiful guitar.
Yeah, that's a special one, that is. You know, I mean, there'll never be another one like this. Finish, inlay, nothing. You know, that's one off. So
got it.
That's cool.
So, what's the difference between your hand built and the ones that anyone could go on a store and buy? What is
honestly, there's not that much. Obviously, okay. it just comes off a factory line rather than
a
craftsman.
But it's still neck through. Still has.
Yeah, man. Honestly, the one I used in the studio was actually a factory one, not a hand built one.
Gotcha.
So that says it all. You know.
No. Great.
Sounds as good. You can't really tell. You have to be a real picky connoisseur to notice the difference.
Right,
you know?
Right. And a lot of times, and correct me if I'm wrong, when you get this, these are kind of like the guitars that are built for you, and then the production are made as a, you know, after.
Yes.
After these,
yeah.
You know, number two, this is.
Yeah,
awesome.
I mean, we had to get it perfect before they actually put it in production, you know. So these ones were still kind of prototypes, even though we've done a couple of proper prototypes, and you know, these are the real deal, yeah. And this was another. Custom finish, just like kind of a copper.
So I'll trade you. I'm gonna give this one back to you.
I mean, this one's white and black, says it all, but I think this other one's worth seeing. This was another one they made for the Axe Wound project, which I now use for Bullet. And again, it's just a different finish, you know, something I'd never seen before.
Sure.
It's got these crazy kind of copper inlays.
So these copper inlays actually match the copper on the body.
Yes, yeah. We wanted something that was just kind of unique, and
yep.
I'd never seen anyone with a guitar this color before, you know, so. That's what BC Rich were really wanting to do with me, was stuff that they'd never done before and they'd never seen before, and this especially is, I'm maybe on some kind of like really exotic PRS models you might use some stuff like this, but you know, for BC Rich this is definitely, again, a one-off guitar.
This is very exciting for me. I grew up with BC Rich, so it's a brand that's near and dear to my heart. And the thing I always liked about them, even from the early days, you can get something very affordable or you could get something very ornate,
yeah.
And it's always good quality. Even the affordable stuff, they're very custom. You always feel like you have that custom shop because there's a lot of differentiators in BC Rich that you don't see in other brands, and I dig it.
Yeah, man. Yeah, they're beautiful guitars, man, honestly, and the factory ones are, you know, that there's a little bit of a difference, but like I said, you have to be a real picky guy. But for the value, it's unbelievable. You know what I mean? The you know, these things cost a bit,
yep.
but the factory run ones are super affordable and they sound just as good. So
love the BC Richesa.
I actually
have an Eagle that has that exact headstock.
Right on, man.
With the R.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is awesome. Thank you for sharing these.
Yeah,
with
no
me.
Problem, okay. Man.